Now I have the honor to invite Professor Dr. Karachevstev from the Institute of Low Temperature Physics and Energy in Frankfurt. His presentation will be connected with photoluminescence enhancement from semiconducting carbon nanotubes due to amino acid doping influence of the polymer coverage on the external.
In my report, I talk about photoluminescence from semiconducting simple carbon nanotubes. We showed the introduction and talk about origin of photoluminescence from this carbon nanotubes, and then we discussed the flames of. I mean, I don't know being a variation of luminescence. We discussed the enhancement from carbon and just after talking about luminescence. And also, we considered different factors affect the process of the enhancement to the processing flow, such as ultraviolet radiation of suspension.
Thank you.
bases absorbed to the surface instead, while shooting was not controlled directly to water. Atom force images demonstrated individual carbon nanotubes, carbon tracings for 20 mm. This symmetry of bulges around this individual nanotubes. Note that some segment of the surface is suffering from polymer.
Thank you.
is a structure, but if it from this amino acid open, it's not above the 3%.
Intensity
applications that decay at the risk of in this structure. Another external factor is sanitation. We use tool dryer, tip sanitation, bus sanitation method, which is used for preparation of nanotube suspension, this polymer. In this case, we also observe shift dependence and density of the sustained moment. When we use tip sanitation, we have a C shape of the concentration tube, which shifted to the lower concentration compared to the nanotube prepared by bus indication. Another aspect also indicates that D-band after chip sanitation preparation increases intensity of this band by 15%. Comparison with bus indication, it's well known that chip sanitation has higher power applied directly to the nanotubes and reduce defect in the carbon surface. And last external factor is pH of suspension. When we change pH before it was obtained at pH about 7, when we shift this pH decrease or increase for pH of 7, this change of pH leads to shift of the concentration to higher concentration sustain and to decrease of influence of the whole sustained addition of the nanotube emission. This is explained the decrease in density explained by the low pH created in the system in a chloric acid. Which also protonates nanotube surface and density of carbon nanotubes decrease. And also, when we add sustain in this suspension, this low pH, hydrochloric acid became direct this sustain. Weaken influence of sustained doping of the enhancement. At higher pH, on the contrary, we get alkali in the solution, and this molecule began to compete this sustain for interaction with this PGP on the nanotube surface. And last conclusion. First conclusion, sustained addition in the suspension was the largest changes in the nanotube photoluminescence among amino acid style. Due to the sustained field group, which reduced the defect of nanotubes. The second conclusion, our experimental method emission from carbon nanotubes can be exploited fully for monitoring of sustained mineral solution in the range between 50 to 1,000 micromole, which includes a range of sustained contents in human organism. And last conclusion, the polymer high ratio of nanotubes and external condition applied during or after suspension preparation the opportunity of achieving the PM intensity concentration dependent that can be useful for sensing application. Thank you very much for your attention.
Can you please tell about the quality of your nanotubes? Can you please tell about the quality of your nanotubes? Are they semiconducting or metallic? And what is the concentration of defects in the nanotubes? And, for example, if you change other manufacturer can absorb the same effect on it.
This is the beginning of my report. I told that we produced the so-called Comacat method, which gives about 95% of semiconducting nanotubes. Among them, nanotubes with this 6.5 chirality prevail in starting material more than 50% or 60% defects. We don't estimate the value of the defect. We can change this value. We can increase defect after ultraviolet radiation or applied different solidification method, which induced additional defect. But literature data give us information that this in such nanotubes we have a few defects along 100 nanometers.
Are you satisfied?